Well, shares in Greatland Gold shot up this morning on the back of an announcement that they signed a deal with giant Newmont Mining, which it said could accelerate the realisation of the potential value of the Ernest Giles project in Western Australia. Chief Executive Gervaise Heddle is with me on the line. Gervaise, good morning to you.
Good morning, Andrew. How are you?
Very good, thanks, Gervaise. I suspect you're the same. A great name here.
Yes.
Tell me a bit more about what this deal involves.
Yes, absolutely. It's a great day for Greatland. You know, we think this is a fantastic outcome after several months of back and forth with Newmont. In essence, you know, we've signed a deal with one of the world's top gold producers. You know, we're thrilled that they recognise the potential of the Ernest Giles project to host gold mineralisation. And in essence, you know, they're going to come in, and we expect they're going to roll out their own state-of-the-art proprietary exploration techniques across you know, a fairly vast area of the project. All of this they're doing at their own expense, in essence, to do, you know, to detect you know, gold anomalies across the project and really get their teeth into it. If you like, it's an extended due diligence process, and we think this is just a, you know, fantastic outcome for Greatland shareholders.
You say they'll be looking to detect gold anomalies across the project. I know Ernest Giles, the project itself is huge, isn't it?
It is, particularly since we added ground recently. Last week we announced that we just nearly doubled the size of the project. The project was 1,000 square kilometres. It's now 1,800 square kilometres. We have roughly 200 kilometres of strike of prospective rocks, rocks that are prospective for gold mineralisation. So, look, it's a massive project, and that's part of the appeal to a company like Newmont, which is they are looking for, you know, big areas that could host multiple multi-million ounce gold deposits. You know, we're on record as saying we think that this project could hold, you know, multiple gold deposits of, you know, very significant size. And, you know, clearly Newmont is of a similar view, otherwise they wouldn't, you know, have gone to the time and effort and the expense of getting involved with us and with the project.
So come the end of 6 months, I mean, some of the options on the table, you could be looking at a joint venture. They might be keen to buy it outright.
Yes, look, anything's possible, Andrew. You know, the first step is that they need to get out there and, you know, do their work in the field and then, you know, check their results in the labs and get a better sense of the project. They've also got access to our entire database of all the historic work we're doing, plus the current work we're doing. We're finishing off a gravity survey and a passive seismic survey at the moment. So there's a lot of work to be done, but look, yes, if they're interested, then it comes down to a question of, well, what's the next step? And, you know, we'll have to wait and see. You know, the best thing about this, though, is that, you know, whatever happens, you know, with Newmont going forwards, we are going to get access to their final results from all their proprietary work, which will greatly assist us in our own future exploration efforts if we choose to go that way on our own and do it, keep 100% of the project. But look, if Newmont makes a deal that's, you know, compelling for our shareholders, then clearly we'd consider that.
And whatever happens, I know you didn't talk numbers or anything in this RNS this morning, but looking to be financially beneficial here for Greatland.
Oh, yes. Well, look, the great thing for us as Greatland is there's no additional expense for us at all as part of this deal. So, you know, it's all of the work that is being done at Newmont's expense, and we get the benefit of that. So, you know, this is a great outcome for us. We're going to get a terrific amount of knowledge, I think, from their efforts about potential targets on the belt, and it's not going to cost us a penny.
And just while I got you, Gervaise, I know we touched on it when we spoke last a bit earlier on this year, but you got some pretty decent drill results back from a number of holes. Just remind us what you'd learned there.
Absolutely. So at the end of last year, we completed a wide space drilling campaign at the Meadows target, which is in the far southwest corner of the Ernest Giles project. The results returned showed that the majority of holes intersected anomalous gold. There were some very wide zones of anomalous gold, grades up to 2 grams per tonne, which is a great outcome for, you know, in essence, the first real systematic drilling campaign there at the project. And clearly those results were part of the reason that, you know, Newmont is so attracted to this project, because, you know, we've demonstrated that clearly there is a greenstone belt here, and that that greenstone belt does host gold mineralisation, as do most of the greenstone belts in Western Australia. And so now it's a question of uncovering, well, are there some large high-grade gold deposits here, you know, within this system? And, you know, we're delighted to be working, you know, with Newmont in trying to assess that.
Well, Gervaise, great news this morning. Congratulations. Really good to speak to you once again. Thanks very much indeed.
Yeah, thank you, Andrew.